அஸ்மத் குருபியோ நமஹா, அஸ்மத் சர்வ குருபியோ நமஹா, அஸ்மத் பரம குருபியோ நமஹா. ஸ்ரீமதே ஸ்ரீ லக்ஷ்மீ நரசம்ம பரபிரம்மணே நமஹா. ஸ்ரீமதே சிவன் சடகோபா ஸ்ரீ வேதாந்த தேசிகேந்திர மகா தேசிகாய நமஹா. ஸ்ரீமதே ஸ்ரீ லக்ஷ்மீ நரசிம்ம திவ்ய பாதுகா சேவக சிவன் சடகோபா ஸ்ரீ நாராயண எதீந்திர மகா தேசிகாய நமஹா. ஸ்ரீமதே சிவன் சடகோபா ஸ்ரீ ரங்கநாத எதீந்திர மகா தேசிகாய நமஹா. ஸ்ரீமான் வெங்கடநாதாரிய கவிதார்க்கிக கேசரி வேதாந்தாச்சாரிய வரியோமே சந்நிதத்தாம் சதா ஹிருதி ஞானானந்தமயம் தேவம் நிர்மலஸ்படிகாகிருதிம் ஆதாரம் சர்வ வித்யானாம் ஹயக்ரீவமுபாஸ்மஹே. வந்தே பிருந்தாவனசரம் வல்லவீஜனவல்லவம் ஜயந்தி சம்பவம் தாம வைஜயந்தி விபூஷணம் ஜன்மாத்யசயதோன்வயாதித்தரதசாத்தேஷ்வபிஜ்ஞஸ்வராடு தேனே பிரம்மகதாயஹாதிகவையே முகியந்தியசூரயா தேஜோவாரிமிருதாம் யதா விநிமயோ யத்ர த்ரிசர்கோ மிருஷாம் தாம்னா சேன சதா நிரஸ்தகுஹகம் சத்யம் பரம் தீமஹி தர்மப்ரோஜித கதைவோத்ர பரமோ நிர்மத்சராணாம் சதாம் வேத்யம் வாஸ்தவமத்ர வஸ்து சிவதம் தாபத்ரயோன்மூலனம் ஸ்ரீமத் பாகவதே மகாமுனி கிருதே கிம் வா பரைரீஸ்வர சத்யோ ஹிருத்ய வருத்தியதேத்ர கிருதிபிகி சிசுரூஷுவி தத்தக்ஷணாத் நிகம கல்பதரோர் கழிதம் பலம் சுகமுகாத் அமிர்தத்ரவ சம்யுதம் பிபதர் பாகவதம் ரசமாலயம் முகுரகோ ரசிகாபுவி பாவுகா யம் பிரௌரஜன்னம் அனுபேதமபேத கிருத்யம் தொய்பாயனோ விரககாதர ஆஜுகாவ புத்ரேதி தன்மயதயா தரவோபினேதுகு தம் சர்வபூதஹதயம் முனிமானதோஸ்மி நாராயணம் நமஸ்கிருத்யம் நரஞ்சைவ நரோத்தமம் தேவீம் சரஸ்வதீம் வியாசம் ததோ ஜயமுதிரயே கிருஷ்ணாய வாசுதேவாய தேவகீ நந்தனாய ச நந்தகோபகுமாராய கோவிந்தாய நமோ நம நம பங்கஜநாபாய நம பங்கஜமாலினே நம பங்கஜநேத்ராய நமஸ்தே பங்கஜாங்கிரயே. வேதத்தை வேதத்தின் சுவைப்பயனை விழிமிய முனிவர்கள் விழுங்கும் கோதலின் கனியை நந்தனார் களிற்றை குவலையத்தோர் தொழுதேத்தும் ஆதியை அமுதை என்னை ஆளுடை அப்பனை ஒப்பவரெல்லா மாதர்கள் வாழும் மாடமாமையிலை திருவல்லிக்கே நிகண்டேனே. வசுதேவ சுதம் தேவம் கம்சசாணூரமர்தனம் தேவகி பரமானந்தம் கிருஷ்ணம் வந்தே ஜகத்குரும் சாந்திரானந்தாவபோதாத்மகம் அனுபமிதம் கால தேசாவதிப்யாம் நிர்முக்தம் நித்தியமுக்தம் நிகம சத சகசிரேண நிர்வாசியமானம் அஸ்பஷ்டம் துஷ்டமாத்திரே புனரரு புருஷார்த்தாத்மகம் பிரம்மதத்வம் தத்தாவத்பாதி சாட்சாத் குருபவனபுரே அந்தபாக்கியம் ஜனானாம். தொட்ட படையெட்டும் தோலாத வென்றியான் அட்டபுயகரத்தானஞ்ஞான்று குட்டத்து கோள் முதலை துஞ்ச குறித்தெறிந்த சக்கரத்தான் தாழ் முதலே நங்கட்கு சார்வு நாராயணாவோ மணிவண்ணா நாகனையாய் வாராய நாரிடை நீக்காய். திஸ் இஸ் 17th லெக்சர் ஆஃப் தி கஜேந்திர மோக்ஷம். இன் தி லாஸ்ட் கிளாஸ் வி ஆர் லுக்கிங் அட் தி 15th ஸ்லோகா. இஃப் யூ டேக் தி பாகவதம் அஷ்டமஸ்கந்தம் 8th ஸ்கந்தம் 3rd சாப்டர் 15th ஸ்லோகா. தி ஃபஸ்ட் ஸ்லோகா இஸ் பேசிக்கலி ப்ரிலூட் அண்ட் தென் கஜேந்திர ஸ்துதி இஸ் கமிங். So if you look at the prabhati.com, only Gajendra Sthuti is put over there. So it will start from the second one. So it's the 14th sloka Gajendra is praying. But in Bhagavatam book, it is the 15th sloka. Namo namaste agila karanaya nishkaranaya adbhuta karanaya sarvagamamnaya మహార్ణవాయ నమో అభవర్గాయ పరాయణాయ. సో బ్యూటిఫుల్ శ్లోగా ఆఫ్ ఆల్ ది గజేంద్ర మోక్షం శ్లోగా. ఈచ్ ఓన్ ఈస్ వండర్ఫుల్, బట్ దిస్ ఓన్ ఈస్ సో స్పెసిఫికలీ పాయింట్స్ అవుట్ భగవాన్ ఈజ్ సో యునీక్ దాన్ ఎనీథింగ్ ఎల్స్. సో సో మెనీ అడ్జెక్టివ్స్ హెస్ పుట్, అండ్ అడ్జెక్టివ్స్ ఆర్ వెరీ స్మాల్ వన్, జస్ట్ లైక్ ఆండాల్ యూసెస్ ఇన్ త్రిప్పావై. సో మచ్ మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ దట్ వన్. సో వీ స్టార్టెడ్ లుకింగ్ అట్, అండ్ దట్ ఈస్ రీజన్ వై గజేంద్ర ఇస్ కాల్డ్ గజేంద్ర ఆళ్వాన్, బికాస్ వీ కాల్ హిమ్ యాస్ ఎ గజేంద్ర ఆళ్వాన్. ప్రహ్లాద ఆళ్వాన్, గజేంద్ర ఆళ్వాన్ వీ కాల్, బికాస్ దర్ స్థుతీస్ ఆర్ సో నైస్ లైక్ ఆళ్వార్. దే ఆర్ సో మెస్మరైజ్డ్ ఇన్ భగవద్ గుణం అండ్ భగవాన్స్ స్వరూప రూప గుణ విభూతి ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దమ్. దట్ ఈస్ రీజన్ వై దే ఆర్ కాల్డ్ స్పెసిఫికలీ ఆళ్వార్. సో గజేంద్ర ఆళ్వాన్, సో వీ కెన్ ఆల్వేస్ సే గజేంద్ర ఆళ్వాన్. వాట్ ఈ సేస్ హియర్, ఈ బిగిన్స్ విత్ నమో నమస్తే, నమః నమః తే ఫర్ యూ, తే నమః నమస్తే, నమః నమః టూ ఆఫ్ దమ్. సో ఈ స్టార్టెడ్ యూసింగ్ టూ అండ్ త్రీ ఆఫ్ ది నమః టు ది భగవాన్. యాస్ ఐ టోల్డ్ యూ, ది మోర్ నమః యూ టెల్ క్లెన్స్ యువర్ పావం, ది క్లెన్స్ యువర్ పావం యువర్ జ్ఞానం విల్ బి వెరీ ట్రాన్స్పరెంట్. సో యూ విల్ అండర్స్టాండ్ వాట్ ఈస్ భగవాన్. సో యూ హ్యావ్ టు గో త్రూ, దట్ ఈస్ ద రీజన్ వై యూ హ్యావ్ టు డూ ప్రాస్ట్రేషన్ సో మెనీ టైమ్స్ వెన్ యూ గో టు ది ఆచార్యన్ అంటిల్ హీ సేస్ పూర్వం. సో యూ హ్యావ్ టు బి ప్రాస్ట్రేటింగ్ బికాస్ సో మచ్ ఆఫ్ పావం యూ హ్యావ్ డన్. సో ఆచార్య డస్ నాట్ టేక్ ఎనీ ఆఫ్ దమ్, వెన్ యూ ప్రాస్ట్రేట్ టు హిమ్ యూ ఆల్వేస్ పుట్ యర్ హ్యాండ్ లైక్ దట్, దట్ మీన్స్ ఇట్ గోస్ టు హిస్ ఆచార్యన్, his acharyan, like that it goes to them. So there is no ego or anything. He says, oh, he has done all this sharanagati without knowing he has done some pavam, or by the context he has done some pavam and everything, that's okay, please forgive him. So he is asking his acharya to do that one. That is the reason why we keep on prostrating again and again. The more you do, what happens is your pavams are going away and you are cleaned up. So the jnanam comes about your atma, atma shuddhi, that comes only by prostration. నమో నమః, దట్స్ వాట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ సేయింగ్ హియర్ గజేంద్రన్. యు హ్యావ్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ గజేంద్రన్ ఇస్ సచ్ ఎ వెరీ డిఫికల్ట్ సిచ్యువేషన్. 1000 years హవ్ ప్యాస్ట్ అండ్ ఆల్ ది బ్లడ్ ఈస్ ఊసింగ్ అండ్ ఆల్ ది పస్ ఇస్ కమింగ్ అవుట్, ఆల్ ది ఫిష్ అండ్ అదర్ అనిమల్స్ ఆర్ ఈటింగ్ ది ఫ్లెష్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ అండ్ ఈస్ ఆల్మోస్ట్ ఫెయింటింగ్ అట్ దట్ పాయింట్ కమింగ్ అండ్ నోబడీ ఈస్ హెల్పింగ్. సచ్ ఎ టమల్చువస్ క్రూసిఫయింగ్ కండిషన్. Like you have seen that Jesus is taking all of them, that is for a few minutes. Here for years and years this one is standing there. So crucifying, tormenting, you know, in a simple word you want to put, he was terrorized. That is what happened. Terrorized for not minutes. For 1000 years he was doing like that one. At that time he's raising his hand and asking, Bhagavan, please help me. That is what he was asking at that time. But he is not like any human being. But the words coming out of his heart, it is not coming out of his mouth. That is what Vyasa Bhagavan has written. He is raising the hand and asking for a refuge. At that situation, how beautifully this brain is working, how beautifully he is talking about all the Bhagavan's Arpuda Gunas. That is what he is telling about them. Nama Namate, we said that one. So when he say that one, he is not a human. He is not an ordinary animal. So when he raises the hand, he is asking, please help me. Is he asking the other person? No. It is asking any other animal? No. It is asking Shiva? No. Brahma, Indra, Agni, Vayu, Varunan. Because the qualification is given. These are the qualification whoever is satisfying, that is the one. So far, he told everything just short of Sriman Narayana. Such a beautiful one. Without telling all of them, you figure it out. I am not telling all of them. Go and consult Vedas, go and consult Smriti, go and consult Idigasa. Whatever I told, bring that person. So that is what he was asking for. So that is the way he is praying very nicely. We also the same thing. The reason why we go to Sriman Narayana, mainly only one reason. He is the only one who can give you moksha. Nobody else. If some, Tirukudani Antam used to say so many times, if somebody else was giving, I would have gone there. So, moksha pradhanam, that is what we are interested in. That is why we are going. So, similarly, he puts all these qualities. Tell me who satisfied all of them. Please come and help me. అఖిల కారణాయ నిష్కారణాయ. అఖిల కారణాయ ఫర్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ యు ఆర్ ది రీజన్, యు ఆర్ ది కాజ్ ఫర్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఫర్ ది ఎంటైర్ యూనివర్స్, ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఇన్ ది యూనివర్స్. బోత్ ఆఫ్ దమ్ ఇస్ సీ సో బ్యూటిఫుల్. అఖిల కారణాయ విన్ ఈ సేస్ దట్ వన్, నాట్ ఓన్లీ ది యూనివర్స్ ఇస్ క్రియేటెడ్, యు నో దట్ ఫ్రమ్ ప్రకృతి మహత్ అహంకారం అండ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్, పంచభూతం అండ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఇస్ క్రియేటెడ్. సో ది మేనిఫెస్టేషన్ నాట్ ఓన్లీ ఆన్ ది మెటీరియల్ పార్ట్, మేనిఫెస్టేషన్ ఆన్ ది హ్యూమన్ బీయింగ్స్ అండ్ అనిమల్స్ అండ్ బర్డ్స్ అండ్ ఫిషెస్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ టు గివ్ ది శరీరం అండ్ ది జీవాత్మ పుట్టింగ్ ఇన్ సైడ్. సో నాట్ ఓన్లీ ది వరల్డ్ బట్ ఆల్సో ఇన్, నాట్ ఓన్లీ బిల్డింగ్ ఎ హౌస్, people are living inside. That's the kind of a thing he is saying. Agila karanaya means both of them is included. Nishkaranaya means you create all of them, you are the cause, but there is no cause for you. See, here we have to understand so beautifully he says agila karanaya nishkaranaya, mainly for you to understand from Shantokya Upanishad, where it says sadvidya pradiganam. So in that one pradibadam, so what it says, the sadvidya కారణం కార్యం. ఇఫ్ యు అండర్స్టాండ్ ది కారణం, కార్యం విల్ బి ఈజీ. ఇఫ్ యు అండర్స్టాండ్ ది మృత్ ది కలిమణ్, ఇఫ్ యు అండర్స్టాండ్ దట్ వన్ క్లే, దెన్ యూ నో ది పార్ట్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ మేడ్. ఇఫ్ యు అండర్స్టాండ్ ది గోల్డ్ బార్, గోల్డ్ యాజ్ ఎ బాల్, దెన్ యూ నో ఆల్ ది ఆర్నమెంట్స్ మేడ్. సిమిలర్లీ ఇఫ్ యు అండర్స్టాండ్ ది భగవాన్, ఆల్ ది మేనిఫెస్టేషన్ యూ విల్ నో. So that is what it's basically. Sadvidya is one of the 32 vidyas. Madhu vidya, dakra vidya, sadvidya is one of them. So that sadvidya is one, that is what he is pointing out here. Karanam. See, let me put this way, just like the other class also I told you, when you say something like nitric acid, HNO3, something like that one. If you say hydrogen, nitrogen and oxygen and everything, so you try to break into that one. Finally, you go to the hydrogen, nothing you cannot break. So you go to that level where you cannot go. So karana means you cannot, that is the final one. You cannot pierce, you cannot go inside, that is called karana. Karya means it's a manifestation. So when the manifestation, you can go inside and see what are the components of that. So that is an easy way to understand. So when you keep on going, prakriti and the people and all other kinds of things, finally you go to a place, that is why these people form the God particle. That's what they say now. That is a pinhead. That is what's the Bhagavan. Bhagavan has got all of them over here. So from there, everything is manifested. So sukshmam, sthulam. So that you have to understand here, the sadvidya pradipadakam, what he says, chetana achetana visishta brahmam, which is sukshmam, is the same thing, chetana chetana visishta brahmam, which is sthulam. నల్ల పురుజం చేతన అచేతన విశిష్ట బ్రహ్మం. దిస్ ఈస్ యాక్చువల్లీ ఫ్రమ్ శ్రీ భాష్యం. చేతన అచేతన విశిష్ట బ్రహ్మం, టేక్ వన్ బై వన్. చేతన మీన్స్ ఆల్ ది జీవన్స్ నాలెడ్జ్. వెన్ ఐ సే యూ మీన్స్ నాట్ ది బాడీ, ది ఆత్మ. సో చేతన అచేతన ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ యువర్ బాడీ టు టేబుల్ టు ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఇస్ ది అచేతనం, విచ్ డస్ నాట్ హ్యావ్ ఎనీ సెన్స్, ఇన్ సెన్షియన్ ఆర్ నాన్ సెన్షియన్. Visishta, that is very important one, because abhrudak siddhi, from Perumal to all these materials and us, which cannot be separated. They are always tied together. That is why when you take visishta advaitam, it leans towards advaitam also, it leans towards dvaitam also, depends on how you look at it. If you think both of them as the same, chetana chetana visitta brahmam, that is the only one is there. Is there anything else is there? Ekameva advidiyam, that's the only thing, no second. Because the whole universe, wherever you take, it is only Bhagavan, is the divyatma surubam, and then all the shariram. That's all we have. But if you take that one, Bhagavan's atma is different than our atma, you will never be Bhagavan like that, then it is like dvaitam. So it is also like Advaitam, it is also like Dvaitam, that is why it's called Khadaka Shruti, where linking mechanism, that is the intelligence of Embrumanar, it's been there, Visishta Dvaitam has been there, it is propagated by Bhagavan himself. It is in Vedas, it is in Pancharatra Shastram and everything, but Embrumanar expounded on that one, this is the way to explain all of them, so nicely to show, yes, you are also right, yes, you are also right, depends on how you take. Because in Vedavakyam, later on in the Sivashim, we're going to see several of them. In Vedavakyam, Abheda Shruti, Bheda Shruti, Kadaga Shruti, so many different kinds of things would be there. How do you explain? Because from the one corner to all the way to the other corner, every single word of Veda is important. You cannot ignore. You cannot say these are Mahavakyam, you discard that one. Or Dvaitam says something like that. See, because it is Adhinam, it's Bhagavan's Adhinam are like, so that is why it says one. So we are all Bhagavan's Adhinam. So that's why Advaitis are saying there's only one. Even though you are different, servant is different and Yajamanan is different. It cannot be one. But they are in the same house, he wants them, that's why one, they call like that. That's why Dvaitam says, both of them are correct, that's what he is saying. So here, Agila Karanaya, Nishkaranaya, the Nishkaranaya goes back to the Sadvidya program, says that he is the starting point, and that one, what changes? Only thing, the manifestation, you don't change, you are the same. Bhagavan does not change. Only thing, the raw material, the prakriti, it keeps on changing and you take a place into that. Previously, you take a place and Bhagavan's stomach is holding on that one. Now, he gave a place to stay in this body. And then later on, he says, you go to the next Janma, you go to the next Janma, you go to the next Janma, until someday you climb up, cross the Viraja River and go back there. So, all you have to understand, we are the same, Bhagavan is the same, material is the same, material was like that one and material has changed like this. So what has changed? Nothing has changed. That was in a microscopic level, it is a macroscopic level. It is expanded. So that is what he was trying to explain over here. Nishkaranaya. So when you look at this world, when you look at all these manifested products and everything, see, you put a seed and from the seed, the whole tree and everything is coming, roots and everything coming. All of them came from that one. So the seeds, the things would be there in every part of that. If you put a seed for a mango, then you don't get anything else. You get only mango. You're not going to get a orange or you're not going to get a sadgudi. So you'll get only that. So Bhagavan puts that seed. So when you look at that one, there's no other mango. Go back to that one. When you say, Sadeva Swami Edamakra Seed, Egameva Dvidhiyam. Sajadiya Vedam, Vijadiya Vedam, Swagadi Vedam. When we say that one, there's only one tree. Mango tree. What is that? Bhagavan is the only one. When it comes out of that, everything is Bhagavan. Next sloka is going to tell so beautifully on that one. So what you see, whether it's in the pralayam or whether you are saying here now after srishti, everything is Bhagavat Mayam. Whole Jagat is Mayam. Whether it is this way or that way, it is Visishtam. It is a shrunk part, it is the expanded part. So if you understand that one, you understand everything. That is what Uttanagar is saying to Swadhagedu, Tattvamasi Swadhagedu kind of a thing. And that is one he wants to point out, keep on going, which cannot pierce. One cannot go inside the other one, go to the final one, that is what it is. So, one small thing I wanted to tell also, when you look at this in our sampradayam, Jivatma is indivisible. Even Bhagavan cannot go inside. That is Desiga's view. In Tengalai, in Manavala Mamanigal and Pillelogacharya, Bhagavan is present even inside the Jivatma. They say that one, but in ours we don't because it is indivisible Atma. But Bhagavan does not have to go inside you to control you. We can control you from outside. We don't need anything. So that is the way Bhagavan controls. So when the Veda says there are two pakshis are sitting there inside you, one pakshi is having that fruits and bhojanam. It's eating all of them. So it gets its karma, punyam and pavam and everything. The other one is sitting and watching. So this is a jivatma which is doing the karma, which is having the palan. Paramatma is just watching that one. That is what the Shruti says that one. So here, agila karanaya, nishkaranaya, when you say that one, all the fabricated materials are there. You go back all the way to the cause. There is only one cause. For that, there is no other cause. Bhagavan does not have any parent. Bhagavan does not have any root. He is himself. That's it. So, next one, it says, Adbhuta Karanaya. Very, very generic term, Adbhutam. And is the cause. Being a cause is not great, Bhagavan. How you do that, that is great. That is what is Adbhutam. He says, you are a cause. We know that one. But how you do that one is incredible. fantastic, marvelous, extraordinary, miraculous, all the adjectives you can say, supernatural. Let's assume you are hungry. Somebody is going to give you food. So you are trying, 3 days I'm not eating food. Somebody says, I'll give you food. Not only they give you food, they give wonderful food. All the varieties of them. Not only wonderful varieties, they put you in a seat and everything. They give you respect and everything. They prostrate like for the Adidi and they give all of them. Not only give that one, I can give you more for you to take. After doing all of them, he's not tired. Nothing is reduced from him. If you see like that one, how would you be happy? Not just giving food, but doing all of them. That is why Bhagavan is unbelievable when Deshika says, Praya prabhadane pumsam paunapunyam nivarayan hastasriya rangabhattur mam avyat abhayamudridaha. He says, Praya prabhadane pumsam, when we go and do prostrate once, Bhagavan says, purum. Why? One time you do prostration, one time you do sharanagadi, I give the entire moksham for you. Please don't do second time. I become pauper. I don't have anything to do. That is Deshika San Kumar Vardacharya's explanation. This is what Swami Desikan is saying over here. That is why Sharanagari you do only once. So Bhagavan says, don't make me as a kadanali. That is what he has written. So don't make me as if I have to give you something. I got the loan from you. I had to return it back. So don't make me like that. So that's why here says, Atpuda Karanaya, having done all of them, Bhagavan is not tired. Bhagavan, nothing has reduced. The next word is beautiful. Sarva Agama Amnaya. In this one thing is compressed into all Shruti, Smriti, Itihasa, Purana, Agama. Everything is compressed. Sarva in all. Agama Shastras, I'll tell you in a moment. Amnaya. Amnaya has got several meanings. First one you can take. Amnaya means Amnaya Gandhi Rudhidha Spurida Daroshtam. Asra vilekshana manukshana mandahasam. Krishna opens his mouth. What kind of a smell you will be getting? All Vedam, Shruti smell. Everything coming out of Krishna's mouth. Amnaya Ganda. Deshika wrote in Gopala Vimshati. So here, Amnayam means Veda, Shruti. That's what it means. So Sarva Agama Amnaya. So when you take Shruti, Smriti, Itihasa, Purana, Agama. So you put the bookends, everything is included. Sarva Agama Amnaya. And here also, Gajendran is so beautiful. First thing he puts is Agama. Agama Sastram is important. I'll tell you in a moment why the Agama Sastram is very important for us more than the Shruti. Because from the Agama Sastram only we are learning Prabhatti. From the Agama Sastram only we are learning Shalagrama Aradhana. Agama Sastram only we know what is our Nitya Karma Anushtanam. Everything is coming from there. So that is why Sarva Agama Amna. I can tell only what I know. Why are you getting up in the morning? All the different kinds of procedures we do. When you get up, you brush your teeth, come back and you do the Achamanam. Everybody, male and female. So yeah, they do the Achamanam in the morning 2 times. So when they do that, why are you doing like that one? Because that is what is prescribed. That is what our Acharya has taught. Where they get it is coming from Agama Sastram. So that is why Sarva Agama. Do you know about the Vedas that tells all this? Oh, I don't read Vedas. I don't know anything. So you go only what you know from. That is why Sarva Agama Amnaya. So he puts over here, Shruti, Smriti, Itihasa, Purana, Agama Sastram. In that order of Supreme Court we said, but for us to understand, the easiest part is Agamam, and then the Puranam, then the Itihasam, then the Smriti, then finally the Shruti. Shruti is very difficult. That is the reason why the Shruti is taken as an Itihasam, given as a story fashion for us. Ramayana Mahabharatam. In Agama Sastram, you don't have to know anything. Just do this. Bhagavan would be happy. That is what they are telling. So, Sarva Agama Amnaya, so beautifully arranged that word over here. The other one you can think of, Agama means Agama Sastram. Amnaya means series of families. So, not one, whole group of them. Agama Sastram, whole group of them there. I'll tell you in a moment, are there several Shaiva, they have Agamam, Shakti, they have Agamam, and Vishnu, they have Agamam. In Vishnu, Pancharatram, Vaigana Samarde, all these Agamams, finally, where does it go? Only to you, Narayana. So that is the family of all the things. That's what, a series of them, a group of them, cluster of them, that is called Amnaya. So in each way you can take it, whether it is a Vedas or you can take it as a cluster. So in all of them is celebrated. Next one is Maharnavaya. Maharnavaya. So this one is the ocean, Maha ocean, big ocean. So Bhagavan is always compared to the ocean because for so many different kinds of reasons. One, because of the color, and two, because of the depth of that one. Three, it's got a lot of valuable thing. Finally, what do you learn from Uddhava Gita? Anything you throw into the ocean, it throws back to you. You give 5 cents to the Perumal in the undi, he gives the $5 million back to you. That is the Perumal's nature. That is the reason why it is compared to the ocean. Because I am taking my hand and praying to you, one small thing I am doing, Bhagavan, I am so confident, you will bless me with million things. So that is why Gajendra Alvan here, it says, Maharnavaya. It doesn't stop, it says, Abhavarkaya Parayanaya. Abhavarkam. Abhavarkam means heaven in general. Here it means moksham. We say so many places Abhavarkam, even in Sistavam. Even the initial slogan itself says Surga Abhavarka. So we say that one. So all those kinds of things, Surga Abhavarkam. When you say it like that, Surgam and moksham. Kuratharvan separates that one. So Abhavarkam means here is moksham. But in general in Sanskrit dictionary it says heaven, Surgam. That's all it says. Parayanaya, Parayanam. Again, this ayanam word is very, very important because that is how we are going to find the Nashtakshram Narayanaya. Okay? To show that one, it does not want to tell exactly Narayana. Without telling, it tries everything. Parayanaya, Parayanam. Highest. Ayana means so many different ways you can do. One of them you can think of is Ayana means place of refuge. Highest place of refuge. In Ashtakshram, when you say, it's a Rakshagan. That is why we go to him. Narayana Pada meaning, the most important meaning is Rakshagan. That is why we go. And then supporter and all other things are there. Rakshagan is important. And that is what he is pulling. Because when you are having this clutches of this crocodile for 1,000 years, you want Rakshagan from him, nothing else. You don't really want a Puliyodhara or Jalebi at this point. You want your life. Somebody has to give you the refuge. That is a Parayanaya, correct word. One word short, Narayanaya you could have used, but you didn't use that one. And then another one say, Parayana, very carefully is used. Parayanam, Dakshinayanam, Uttarayanam. Dakshinayanam means it is going towards Dakshina. Going towards Uttara. That is Uttarayana. Ramayanam. What is Ramayana meaning? Rama's movements. Okay? Rama is moving everywhere. So, Parayanam. The crocodile is holding me. Where I am going to go? Towards a good place. Towards moksham. Parayana. So, very carefully, Narayana Padam, I used it. It will mean only one thing. If I use Parayana, it is both the Ubhayam and the Palan. So that is the reason why Gajendra uses this Parayanaya, and also without telling the name. You figure it out. I'm not going to tell you. So the Gajendra used so nicely spelling out, and very carefully he has used each one of the words, multiple meanings. Just like I told you this one. Sarva Agama Amnaya. Agama Amnaya. Agama, one side, the other side is Veda. So, Shruti, Smriti, Itihasa, Puranam, you can take. Or, Sarva, Agama, Agama, Amnaya means family of them. Several kinds of Agama Sastram, Pancharatram and Vaiganasam and everything. You can take any which way you want. And also, when he puts that one, Sarva, Agama, Amnaya, Sarva, Amnaya, Agama, he didn't put that one. First, Agama Sastram. That is what is important. And the whole sloka here, if our Purvacharya would explain, it tells about Pancharatra Sastram. This sloka. So far it's talked about all these Vedas and everything. Here is the Pancharatra Sastra we're going to tell in a moment. Yeah. Abhavarga Parayanaya. So now let's go for the Swabadesam. This is what we saw in that one. Now the Swabadesam part of that. So even Anyabadesam itself is very complex with Gajendra. So in the last sloka we said Sarva Pratyaya Hedave. Remember that one. From the manifested world, from the sthulam, we understand the sukshmam. This is the inverse of the sadvidya. In the sadvidya, what we are saying, if you know the gold, you know the ornaments. If you know the clay, you know the parts. Bhagavan, I am seeing the parts. There has to be some material. And that material has to be the only one. I look at all this thing and he has to be super intelligent. So we are taking the reverse part of that one. So that is why I know how to come to your home, but I don't know how to come back now. We need both ways. Yeah. So that is why Sadvidya Praganam says like that one. Here it says the other way. Sarva Pratyaya Hedave. When I look at all this manifested world, it cannot come that simple. It cannot be created overnight. It cannot be created by ordinary, stupid, intelligent people like we are. We are all having such a minimal knowledge. We don't even know what is going to happen 5 minutes later. That is what we are. Somebody who has to. That is why Sarva Karanaya. Next one he started. So saying he has to be so good. Some manifested to the micro level he is going over there. See here also so many words he is using. What Gajendra Stuti he can compare to Sri Vishnu Sahasranama. People who cannot say Sri Vishnu Sahasranama, they can do the Gajendra Stuti. What he has said in 1008 words, maybe Gajendra told about 60 or 70 words. All of them there, and probably even more than that. Even more than, because each word can multiple meanings, you can figure it out. So people who cannot say that one, you can say, because it points out only to him. At least in Sri Vishnu Sahasranama, many places it says about Perumal. His explicit names are coming. Here, none of the name comes. We'll point out only two. You figure it out. So nicely then. Agila Karanaya Nishkaranaya. When we say that one, where does he get that one? He is the cause for everything. And for him, there is no cause. Okay? Desigan says in Adhikara Sangragam, Bhagavan is the owner. இலது ஒன்று எனவகை எல்லாம் தனது எனும் எந்தையுமாய். There is nothing in this universe which does not belong to him. From that angle, everything he owns that. See, you have to go to the negative case. He owns everything. Anna. Negative goes to inverse. There's nothing exists. So you have to have both of them. Just like Anugolya Sangalpam and Pradyugolya Varjanam, we want to make sure it is very clear. No ambiguity at all. That is the reason why he says, Iladu ondru enavagai ellam thanadenum endayumai. Where Desigan takes that one? Gajendra Stuti. Agila Karanaya Nishkaranaya. You are the cause for everything and there is nothing for you. How beautifully the opposite sides and everything is linked to one. And not only this, I told you previously, you might not remember, I told you Adi Bijaya. Gajendra is talking to Perumal. Not to you, he's talking to the Perumal. I'm telling you before, Adi Bijaya, Atma Moolaya, Moola Prakrutiye. No, you didn't listen to me. I told everything comes only from you and you don't have anything to as a root. You are the cause. Nothing else is in front of you. So here he wants to say very specifically. So many times I told this way, but you are not listening. Now I want to say, Agila Karanaya Nishkaranaya. Do you still understand? I'm only talking to you. Nobody else. That's what it was saying. Because Perumal later on is going to say, I looked everywhere. Nobody went. That's why I came. He's going to say that one. So where does it take? Ego Havai Narayana Asit. Na Brahma, na Isanaha. Shruti Vakyam. Narayanan Urvandhan Irundhan. Undrum, Devum, Ulagum, Uyurum, Yadum, Allah, Andru. Exact translation. Alvar. Alvars have 4000 Divya Prabandham slogans. And Anantavai Veda. Vedas are unlimited, countless. You can say anything. But I am going to die in another 30 seconds. I have only 28 slogas, like Tirupanalvar. That is why it says over here, in a compressed fashion, Agila Karanaya, Nishkaranaya points to all of them. Ego Havi Narayana said, Narayanad Brahma Jayade, Narayanad Rudro Jayade, Narayanad Indro Jayade. From Narayanan, Brahma came. From Narayanan, Rudran came. From Narayanan, Indran came. What else you want? These people are trying so hard to tell all of them. I told in two words. Gajendran says this one. Oh, go to Alvar. Avane, avanum, avanum, avanum. Avane, avanum, avanum, avanum. What is this avanum, avanum, avanum?
Brahma, Vishnu,
Sivan. Not only that, Atpuda Karanaya, where vittai mudalai. That is also that. In Atpuda Karanam, we will take that one. So many different ways. That is why he says that way. Kadalnyalam seidenum yane yendrum. Kadalnyalam avenum yane yendrum. I created this ocean. I created this universe. I am this universe. I am this ocean, Bhagavan says. How do you know that one? Go back to this word. What? Agila Karanaya, Nishkaranaya. He is the cause and there is no cause for him. Again, it's the same thing. All Shruti Vakyam says, you told in two beautiful words. That suffices. You don't have to tell anything more. That is why many times our Acharyas, not many times, all the time our Acharyas says, in the morning when you wake up, you always think of Gajendra Moksha. And so, Grahakrasde Gajendra Irvadi, that slogan, from next class onwards, in the prelude slogan, we'll shrink that one and we'll go through all the Gajendras to the slogan, whatever we have done so far, and the morning slogan, what you have to tell. In the morning, you always have to think of Gajendra Moksha. Because why? When you come from that one, when you wake up, the crocodile is going to catch you. That is the reason, as soon as you get up, you have to think of Gajendra Moksha. Another reason, Nishkaranaya. Again, I tell you, every word he puts it so interesting. Nishkaranaya. Bhagavan, you don't need a reason. Why? Because Nirheduga Kripai. Nishkaranaya Bhagavan, for you to be given the refuge, for you to get in the adakkalam, for that one, Bhagavan does not need any reason. I am shouting all of them, but I know you don't need any of them. Go back to the Ragasetra Saram at the beginning, what we say, to go to the Acharyan, only through Acharyan we get only moksham. To go to the Acharyan, six things are there. The first one is Nirheduga Kribai, Karanamila Karunai, costless compassion. When they put CC, that is what? Not carbon copy, costless compassion. That is what is called CC. So Bhagavan is a CC. I'm watching, he's saying that one. CC, costless compassion. He's watching. But the next one you need, Yadrichika Punyam. He's seeing all of them, but it has to happen at some point. So, Pungum Parivale. So Bhagavan's erupting. When can I help him and everything? We take one sloka to explain this one. Whatever we said is exactly applicable only to Krishna. Nothing else. All these things what we told only applies to Krishna. How is that one? There is a Brahma Samhidai. Brahma Samhidai is coming from Pancharatra Sastra. In Pancharatra Sastra, so many Samhidais are there. One of them Brahma Samhidai. In that one, Brahma is praying to Krishna. Not Narayana. To Krishna. And the words what he uses, that one, and overlap with words here. Ishvara Parama Krishna Sachidhananda Vigraha Anadir Adir Govindaha Sarvakara Karanam. Ishvara Parama Krishna. Krishna, you are the Ishwaran and you are the Param, final one. There's nobody. So don't come with this Narayana and Rama and Govinda. Krishna. Brahma says that one because he got a huge slap from Krishna. That is why he is praying back. So because he took all this all these cowboys and everything. And when Perumal created everything, He saw that one. Then he got so surprised. Then only he knew what's the problem he was making, the ego. So he says, Ishvara Parama Krishna. Krishnan is the final. There's nothing. So that is what he says. Sachidananda Vigraha. Sati Chitti Anandam. So beautiful, he says. Don't go to Sachidananda Brahmam. What Advaitis were telling. Here, Sat. Sat means Irk. Chit means knowledge. Anandam. Chit, Jnanam, and Anandam is there. That means Jivatma is there, Paramatma is there. That they said already. So it will not go to Advaitam. Sat, Chit, Anandam. The Chit is Sat. Chit is there. Anandam is Sat. Anandam is there. So Jivatma is there, Paramatma is there. Both of them separate. So beautifully says, Sachidananda Vigraha. Vigraha. That itself is gone when they Advaitam. Because Perumal has got a Trimeni. Okay. Anadir Adir. Anadihi Adihi. What is that? That's what we told. Sarvakaranaya Nishkaranaya. You are the Adi. For you, there is no Adi for you. You are the cause. There is no cause for you. So what we told, that is what Brahma has told in the Samhire. And Pancharatra Sastram, that's what we think the highest one for us. And for Sri Vaishnavas, Pancharatra Sastram is the most important one because that tells you what you should be doing. And Krishna himself says in another place in Bhagavad Gita, Aham sarvasya prabhavo matta sarvam pravartade. Aham sarvasya prabhavo. I am the reason for everything to be born. Coming from Krishna's word. What it means, from the sukshmam to go into the sthulam, I am the one making all of them. Matta sarvam pravartade. In addition, only by me, everything else is operating. This is the word from Krishna in Bhagavad Gita in the 10th chapter. So Krishna says, I am the one creating, I am the one making everything to run. So when you look at that way, everything comes from him. Everything emanates from me. All the things, not only you and the Jivatma and all other kinds of things like taking the Shariram and everything. Everything, Rama, Krishna and Varaga and Vamana, everything comes from me. Krishna says. So that is the reason why some of the other Gujaratis and everything, when they do, Krishna is at the center and everything else is coming from them. Because Krishna himself has told.
Like Narayaniyam.
Eh? Narayaniyam also, that's what they say. So it's taken from the Bhagavatam, that's why. But if you really look at that one, Saulabhyam and Sausilyam and everything only with Krishna, nowhere else. And that is the reason why we hold on to that one. So, the thing here, the next one it says, Atpuda Karanaya. We go and analyze by so many different ways. It's a one word, put so many things into that. Bhagavan does all of them. Let's take about him. When he does, Paravasudevan coming to Vyuga, Vasudevan, Sangarshanan, Pradyumnan, Aniruddhan. From the Aniruddhan comes a Keshavadi and everything, all the 12. And then all the avatarams and everything coming. Because all these things are coming. Let's assume when I have young, then I grow old, we have more kids, we support them in everything. So when I start supporting them, oh, don't bother me. I've been working so hard to earn money for you. We show the tiredness. We show vikaram. Bhagavan does not have any vikaram, even though there are thousands of Krishnas and Vamanas and Varagas and Narsimhas are born. He's still so happy in Paramapadam. He's still so happy in the Tiruparkadal and everything. So, no vikaram from his own part. Forget about others. We're going to come into the other things over here. The way he does that one is Atpudam, because no vikaram. No vikaram means what? No change. No change is called Satyam. Satyam is what? No change. That is called Satyam. So, the first guna for Perumal, Satyam. Satyam, Jnanam, Anandam. So that's how you start with that one. Satya means no change. He is always the same. So without any tiredness, without any decrement in anything, unchanged. Unchanged in what? Any parameter you take, nothing is changed. That is what he says. He's got unlimited knowledge, jnanam, strength, balam, wealth, and the lordship is the aishwaryam, valor, and bravery is a viryam, energy and vigor, that is the shakti, splendor and brilliance, which is the tejas, and all the six put together, because Bhagavan is creating all of them, from the micro level to the manifested level, when he takes the thousands of avadaram, and each of these under he takes a different avadaram and everything, is any iota a shrink in him? Nothing. Bhagavan, that is what is arputam. Gajendran says, it is not your cause of all of them, but the way you do. நல்ல ஃபர்ஸ்ட் கிளாஸாக சாத்தமுது பண்ணியிருக்க ஆத்துலனா பிரமாதம் நீ சாத்தம் நல்லதில்ல ஒரு பத்து நிமிஷத்துக்குள்ள அப்படி டக்கு டக்குன்னு போட்டு பண்ணிட்டியா தே சே லைக் தட் தட் இஸ் வாட் இஸ் நாட் தி குவாலிட்டி பட் ஹவு யூ மேட் தட் ஒன் ஒன்றுமே வீட்டில் இல்லை வேலை தரிசனம் கருவேப்பில் தரிசனம் தக்காளி தரிசனம் திஸ் ஒன் பட் ஸ்டில் யூ மேட் தட் ஒன் தட் இஸ் வாட் இஸ் அற்புதம் பகவான் தர்ஸ் நத்திங் யூ ஆர் ஆல் அலோன் பட் யூ மேட் எவ்ரி திங் தர் இஸ் நோ சகாயம் ஃபார் யூ ஆஃப்டர் யூ டூயிங் ஆல் ஆஃப் தம் ஸ்டில் யூ ஆர் நாட் டயர்ட் And nothing is reduced from you. That is what is Arputam. Arputa Karanaya applies only to you. Because all others, there is some decrement. There is no decrement for you. Where does it come? It is coming from Upanishad. So, Janmat Yasya Yadaha. First, we start at Brahma Sutram. Janmadi Asya Yadaha. From where everything is come. Agila Karanaya, Nishkaranaya, Atpuda Karanaya. Vyasa Bhagavan telling in Brahma Sutram all these things, I'm telling in three phrases. Three phrases. There's nobody cause for you. You're the cause of everything. And the third one he says here, the way you do is miraculous. Atpuda Karanaya is the one, that is what the whole first chapter, after the first two, four Brahma Sutra, we're going to deal with. How he does. Oh, he has to learn somewhere. No. Tailor has to make the cloth. Potter makes the pot. Goldsmith makes this one. There are three people we see. No, he is the only one. Goldsmith is different from the gold, from the hammer. No, he is the same. That is why it's Arputam. Arputam comprises of whatever we talk in the first chapter of the Sribhashyam. So that's what he says here. He is always no shrinkage, no reduction, remains complete. That is why Adbhutam. Where does it come from? Shanti Mantram of the Veda. When you take that, Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachade Purnasya Purnamadhaya Purnameva Vasishyade. What does it say? Purnam Ada. Adaha Purnam. Bhagavan. Adaha Bhagavan is complete. Purnam Idam. Again, how beautifully is when you take Gajendra Moksham one-to-one comparison. Purnam Idam. This world is complete. When Bhagavan makes that one, this is complete. Bhagavan, you are complete. From the Sukshumam, it is manifested into Stulam. This is also complete. Purnam Adaha, Purnam Idam. Purnat Purnam Udachade. From that Purnam Bhagavan, this Purnam world has born. Purnat Purnam Udachade. See everything. Yesterday they told Santakaram Bhojagasayanam. If you sit for a few minutes, it takes only 3-4 minutes. Break all the words, what you are telling. Amazing thing. But we don't know. We just rush through all of them. So we're trying to explain that one. Santakaram, Bhujagasayanam, Patmanabham, Suresham, Vishwakaram, Gayanadarsam, Megavarnam, Subhangam, Lakshmikandam, Kananam, Yogirityanagamyam, Vande Vishnu Bhavayaharam, Sarva Logaikanadam, Sarva Loga Eka Natham. That's it. Done. You have to break that one. When you do that one, this is what I am saying. Sarva, Loka, Yeka, Nadam. He is the only one. That's what your Krishna always says, Mom and Aham. That's what it's over there. So break each one of them. So that is why if you look at it here, Purnam Adaha. Purnam Idam. Purnat Purnam Udachade. From that Purnam of Bhagavan, this Purnam of the world has been brought. Purnamasya Purnamadhaya. Purnamasya. From that completeness, Purnamadhaya. You take some Purnam. From that completeness, you take complete out. What do you get? Purnam eva avasishyade. What you left over is also Purnam. That is what is so beautiful idea. When you look at that one, that's what exactly Gajendran tells over here. Adbhuta Karanaya means here, Purnam is Bhagavan, Purnam is this world. From that Purnam Bhagavan, this Purnam world is come. Very good. That's not great. That is the first line what he says. Agila Karanaya, Nishkaranaya, from that one. The second one is the Adbhuta Karanaya. That is what it is. It means Purnamasya Purnamadaya. Purnam Asya Purnamadaya. From this Purnam, you take the Purnam out. What you have done, you are left with Purnam. You take an infinity out of an infinity. What you left is infinity. We say that one. That infinity is Bhagavan. Why? Because we say infinite gunas are Bhagavan. So infinity is derived from him. Because we cannot have any calculation. So beautifully he says, that is what is Adbhuta Karanaya. Bhagavan, you do not only you are the cause of that, the way you do, that is unbelievable. Is anybody, see in the real world, we say we have a bank balance of $1 million. And then you try to take some money, just like the stock market today. So you saw your asset balance yesterday, and the Dow Jones was 530 points down today. So we record this one, someday we'll watch later. So 500 points down, you see the balance, how much it is. It goes on down. Okay? When you take out anything, or you take it out for eating, you take it out for something else, it goes down. Where do you see you take anything out that stays the same? So that is what it says over here. Bhagavan is so complete, almost innumerable avatarams, innumerable srishti he makes, and he is in all of them. Nothing is reduced. Nothing is reduced in all the attributes. His shakti, jnanam, balam, aishwaryam, viryam, everything. Nothing is reduced. He is still the same. That is what is making, you know. Adbhuta Karanaya. Unlimited. Unlimited in the sense what we really need. Bhagavan, you have unlimited balam. I'm not worried about it. What we need unlimited is the daya, karunai. That is why Maharnavaya, next one he is going to say, daya shagaram. All I need, your compassion on me. That's all I need. I know, I described all these things. Everybody knows how much balam you have, jnanam you have, viryam you have, shakti you have. All these things you have. If you don't have the karunai, just like what he says, it is a, in Daya Sadagam he says, it's a woman, the most beautiful ornament is the Tirumangalyam. That is what you are, Pirumal. If you don't have the karunai, that's what you would be. Says so beautiful on that one. And Alvar says, Nitya Yuva, Bhagavan. You do all of them, still you are a teenager. Nitya Yuva, that's what he says. He does single-handedly everything. Take any of them. The reason why he says Adbhuta Karanaya, if it takes sun, sun will be dead one day, even though it's so great. You see all the sun dam, one day it's going to merge in all dam. For him, there is nothing. There is no laziness. There is no sleep. There is no hunger. There is no thirst. There is no dvayodigam, old age. There is no death. None of them. And when we go in moksham, we get all of them. We get all of these things. Here also you have. For Atma it is. Only body is asking for idli and vada. So Atma does not ask anything. So for the Atma, when it knows sasvarupam, you know what is your sarupam, then you won't be asking. So agaram, agaratraya sambandham. What is the agaram for us? Agamannam, agamannam, agamanna, agamannado, agamannado. When we do the Kaingaryam, it is the agaram for Bhagavan. Bhagavan's Tirkalyana Gunam is the agaram for us. That is the reason. Sada Pashyanti Surayaha. That is the reason. Okay. Sureshwaraha. Santa Akaram. Santa Akaram. is manifested everything in Shantam. Bhujaga Sayanam. Bhujaga means snake, serpent. Sayanam is lying down. Santagaram, Bhujaga Sayanam. Padmanabham, we know that, is having this. Tamare, lotus is coming from his navel. Suresam, Sura, Isan. Sura means Devas. Isan means head. Then Suresh, that is what the name they keep. Suresha, Santagaram, Bhujaga Sayanam, Padmanabham, Suresham, Vishwadharam. We can have two of them. Some books they say Vishwakaram, some books say Vishwadharam. Vishwadharam, what else you need? Narayana Padam. They broke down and tell you the meaning. That's why what Vedas says, we cannot say, that is why Idhigasa Puranas are trying to tell. What Idhigasa Purana also certain kinds of like this one, they put it inside. Even woman cannot say all of them because it's called all the Veda mantras inside. Tell Gajendra Moksha. Whatever the all the Vedas the whole day is telling, in 28 slogas, you tell in 20 minutes and leave. It's got all of them over there. So same thing with Prahlada Stuti also. That is why Gajendra Arvan, Prahlada Arvan. Coming back here, Atpudam. Why is Atpudam? He doesn't need anything. He is self-sufficient. How is self-sufficient? Ubhadana Garnam, Nimitya Garnam, Sagagari Garnam, where? Vittai, Mudalai. Oi, Arvar put three of them. Sadeva Saumye Demakrasit, Yegameva Advidiyam, Sat Asit, Yegam Asit, Advidiyam Asit, Sat Yeva Asit. Only Brahma was there. Yegam Asit. Only that Brahma was there. Advidiyam Asit, without any second. The three over here, what does it show? Sajadiya Vedam, Vijadi Vedam, Sogada Vedam, when it says, when I put a seed over there, when it comes, it gives only mango. It doesn't give you anything else. When the seed only, it's all coming. So what you see is the Bhagavan, Sukshma Rubamana Chetanadeshta Virta Brahmam, Pralayagalam. When it becomes the Srittigalam, it becomes a Sthula Chetana Chetana Visita Brahmam. That is what. So when I am saying, Sat Asit, Egam Asit, Advidiyam Asit. When you say that one, for him, where? Vittai, Mudalai. He is the Vadana Garnam, he is the Nimitya Garnam, he is the Sagagari Garnam. Nothing else is needed. So that is the three things it is showing. Because why? In the Sadvidya Praganam, when the Uttanar is telling the Swadigedu, from what you understand, everything else you will understand. When you understand the Bhagavan, you understand everything. How do you understand the Bhagavan? He is the Sagakari Karanam. He is the Nimitta Karanam. He is the Ubhadana Karanam. Is there anything else is there? Nothing. That's what it is. So from here, you understand here. Not like the Advaitam says, Bhagavan Brahmam is in there, and Brahmam is the only one there. Within that Brahmam, there's nothing else is there. No gunas, no kalyana gunas. No. Because Embirumanar argues in that place, we're saying, what we are talking, whether the Brahmam exists or not, that's what we are not talking. At that place, where Swadhagedu coming and asking, how from the Sukshvam to the manifested come? That is what we are talking. So in that angle, you have to tell, there is no prasakti to tell whether the Brahmam is existing or not. That's not we are arguing. So when you argue how it comes from one to the other, you need three. That three is the Bhagavan, that's what he is showing. So Sadadiya Vedam, Vijadiya Vedam, Sogada Vedam, when he says like that one, all the three reasons what I am showing over here. Vadana Karnam, Nimitya Karnam, Sagakari Karnam, all of them one guy, and that is what you are getting over here. So that is what you have to understand from Sivashyam. That is what here, Atpuda Karanaya. Bhashyakara, you have several pages to explain. I don't have. I have only two words. That is why Gajendran said, Atpuda Karanaya. The next one he says, Sarva Agama Amnaya. This also amazing words here. Agama. The Agama Sastram, when you take, two main Agama Sastrams are there. One is Pancharatram in other one is Vaikanasam. Pancharatram is basically told by Bhagavan himself. Vaikanasagamam is basically told by Vikasana Muni. So it's coming from there. The simple way you can understand, most of the temples what we see, they are all based on Pancharatra Sastram, except Tirupati. Tirupati is Vaiganasam. There are some procedural differences. I'll tell you in a moment what is Agama Sastram tell in four things. There are some differences are there. The most important you have to understand, Pancharatra Sastram, anybody can get the Dikshai. Anybody means, if you are qualified, you'll get the Dikshai. Vaiganasam, you have to be born in that family. It's a royal family. If you are not born in that family, you cannot do Vaiganasam. Okay? So you have to be in that family only. So Pancharatram, anybody, so if he is qualified, you can go and get the Diksha like that one. So coming back here, Amnaya, when he says, Agama Amnaya. Now let's take Amnaya means not Vedas, different types of families, clusters of Agama Sastram. So Agama Sastram basically tells, what do you understand from Agama Sastram? Shruti, Smriti, Itihasa, Puranam, would that be sufficient? No, it is not. That doesn't tell you what we need to do. So why Agama Sastram is important? First of all, it talks mainly about philosophy and spiritual knowledge you need, just like anything else. Second, the yoga and the mental procedure you need to do the Aradhanam for Perumal. And then the last one says, specifics, how do you worship the Bhagavan? That is what is important. So, I'll break it down into four things. Philosophy and spiritual knowledge. Second one, yoga, mudra and a mental attitude. Third one, how do you construct the temple, sculptures, vigraham, the size. All those kinds of things is told in that sastra. And not only you have the nice temple you built based on this sastra, how do you do worship there? What kind of rules you have to observe? And all these things are coming when we do Brahmotsavam. Where do you get that one? It is coming from here. So, what do you do in the Kalailam Vishwarupam? When you have the cow coming and cow is showing the back end of that one to the Perumal and everything. Where do you get this one? This is from here, Agama Sastram. Everything is told that this is how you have to do. This is how all these things, Samprokshanam is done. All of them is coming from here. This Agama Sastram itself is like another Veda. So huge. So huge are that one. Three of them are mainly important. Shaiva, Shakti and Vaishnava. And we take only Vaishnava, Agama Sastram. And that one, two of them, Pancharatram and Vaiganasam. Saiva Parumal, what is Shivan governor there? They do the Agama Sastram there.
Three separate Agama Sastram.
Correct. For them, how to put the lingam, how to do the Abhishekam and everything, they have that one. Mahabharata prescribes only to Pancharatra Sastram. In that one, in the Narayaniya section, there is one of them there. In there, it talks about only Pancharatra Sastram, Mahabharatam. Pancharatra Sastram has got the problem here. Vedas does not have no origin. But Pancharatra Sastram has got origin. Who? Bhagavan. So Vyasa Bhagavan at the end says, Bhagavan has told this one, maybe we can think equal to Vedas. Because it comes from Perumal's mouth, including Krishna's Bhagavad Gita. Vedas is the highest one. Nothing can be done. Only Vedas. Even Perumal himself says, Vedas is a supreme court. Even if it comes from Perumal's mouth, it is only secondary. So,
But we also say, Sastram, Perumal is important.
But how do you interpret that one? Bhagavan says and all of them. You have Narayanan told this one. And they say, if you say Agama Sastram important, that is Saiva, they say something. Shakti, they say something and everything. So that is why we go to the Supreme Court. Try to find out who is the final boss. Okay. So here, Narayana says this one. Ratra means 5 day and night put together. Several people is basically telling. Vishwaksena, Agni and Vayu, other people is telling. That's not important. So that is why it's called Pancharatram. They say, no, that is not the Pancharatram. Pancharatram, two important things. There are so many samhitas. More than 200 samhitas are there. Two important ones what we need. Lakshmi Tantram and then Ahirbhudya Samhita. Okay, these are the two important ones. What Embarumanar before that Alavandar did in those days, you guys are telling Pancharatram and everything. What is the proof for that Perumal said all of them? Somebody could have written like that. So there is no proof for that one. Even though it tells a lot of their thing, we cannot take it. So Yamunachar did the greatest thing is Agama Pramanyam. He did. Agama Sastram is equal to Vedas. It has got Vedic origin. We have to respect and we have to follow. And he is the one who took. For all the things what we do, Yamunachar is the first one who gave everything for us. It has been already there. People discarded. People buried that one. He brought everything. First from Agir Buddhya Samirai, the Prabhatti Sastram. From here, Agama Pramanyam he took. Perumal has got five rubams. Param, Vyugam, Vibhavam, Hardam, Archai. Where do you get that one? Pancharatra Sastram. Pancharatra Sastram says, that is why Pancharatra means these five. That is what people have thought and many people write. It is not five nights Perumal has told. This is what the five of them. So, when you say in Pancharatra Sastram, Vishnu, Bhagavan, Vasudeva, all of them are identical terms. Because we reconcile all of them. So many times we say all of them, we refer to the same guy. That is what we want to say. And the detailed interpretation of all these names. What is Vasudevan? What is Bhagavan? All of them. What is Vishnu? Everything is written there. Agir Buddhya Samhitai. And many people ask, why we have a Sudarsanam in front, Narasimha at the back? That is given in Agir Buddhya Samhitai. He goes through all the details, why we had to do that one. And because we take Pancharatra Sastram on our head, we follow that. That is the reason why we do. Because Pancharatra Sastram is the one that tells you, how do you make all this culture, all these idols, idol worship? How do you make the temple? Where do you have the... So the height of this Dvajastambam and the Goburam height, the length between that front to the Bhagavan and the Garbhagraham, everything has got a measure. You have to follow all of them. So you cannot just openly put it in a glass and do. You can do, that may not be following the Agama Sastram. Okay? Why this Agama Sastram is important? Because so many different Samhitai, I told you. In the one, Ishwara Samhitai, that's one of them. That is what is followed by Melkottai. Ishwara Samhitai. Parameshwara Samhitai, one is there. That is followed by Srirangam. Jakya Samhitai, that is followed by Kanchipuram. Padma Samhitai, that is followed by Thiruvallarai. Sriprasna Samhitai, that is followed by Thirukkudandai. There is no Tirupadi here because they don't follow Pancharatram. They follow Vaikanasam. So these are all the Agama Sastram. Agama Sastram in Pancharatram alone is so huge. That is why when we do, we need an expert in Agama Sastram to build the temple, to build the idol, to make the worship, to do all those kinds of. That is why when you calculate the number of a Brahmotsavam, the number of days done in Srirangam and what is done in Tirupadi are different. Okay, the number of days are more here in Tirupadi. That is because they follow different things. Swami, they first show Kalpuram and then only they show Sambarani. Where do you know that one? That is in coming from there. So all the procedural differences and everything. We have done all these things. When it comes to Thirumangalyadanam, then only they put the Kanganam. We put the Kanganam at the first itself. Well, that is what their Sastram says. So all the procedural differences, you see many of them. So don't ask why they do. This is wrong. We cannot say that one because each one of them. That is why Srirangam is different from Kanjipuram, is different from Melkottai, is different from Thiruvallarai to Thirukkudandai. Each one follows a different kind of them. And that is the reason why those butters are there. It is from so many different generations are coming to them. They know how to do that. That is why we are following that. So, Lakshmi Tandram. Great sloka we always think of. Anukulasya sangalpat pradikulyasya vajjanam rakshasvadi viswaso guptrutva varanam tada atmanikshepa karpanya shadvida sharanagadihi. Agir Buddhya Samhitai, Shivan gave this one. So our Prabhatti Sastram is coming only from that Hagir Buddhya Samhita. Deshigan put so much high respect for Hagir Buddhyan. He is Jnanam. Shivan gives you the Jnanam to go to the Paramat. That is what Deshigan always says, that one. So that is why Hagir Buddhya Samhita is important, and that is the reason why Pancharatra Sastram is important. And Jnana, Bala, Aishwarya, Virya, Sakti, Tejas, who told you all of them? That is from Pancharatra Sastram. Again, it's also told in by Parasara Rishi in a Sri Vishnu Puranam also. The modes of worship, iconic form, temples and homes. And Deshiga told, this is not much important. Param Yugam Vibhavam Ardha Marchai. And 5 nights and he told, no. Panchakala Prakriya. A day is divided into 5 different parts. And what you have to follow in that one, that is what is important. Starting from Abhigamanam, Ubhadanam, Ijhya, Swatyayam, Yogam, all the 5 different kinds. Those are the duties for you. Pancharatra Sastram says what you should be doing. Desian always points out, we should be correct. We should be, don't say anything else. It's you. That's why Krishna, what he says? Tumtu sarvam parityajya. Desian took that one. You be right. As long as we are right, we don't have to say anybody is wrong or anything. So, Desian took this one. It is not Purumals Param Yogam Vibhavam. That may be there. But the more important thing is what you can do in a 5 different parts of the day, what you do that one, that is very important. So, that is what he was saying. And most important in Pancharatra Sastram, it showed Bhagavata Kainkaryam. Bhagavadas are very, very important. Nowhere else it shows that one. Bhagavata Kainkaryam, that is what is explicitly stated. Prabhatti Sastram, Bhagavata Kainkaryam, Bhagavan's Param Yugam Vibhavam, and then our Panchakala Prakriya, what we do in 5 different parts of that one, and idol worship and everything, how do you build the temples and everything, then why do we need Vedas? Pancharatra Sastram is important. That is the reason Sarva Agama Amnaya. Amnaya comes only second. Why? Because I am doing Prabhatti to you. That is what is important. Where Prabhatti Sastram is explicitly told, not in Vedas that much, only in Agama Sastram, only in Lakshmi Tandram and Agir Buddhya Samhita. These two explicitly talk about that one. And the most important for us in Agama Sastram, it says Shri Tattvam. Shri Tattvam is explained because Lakshmi Tandram, in that one, Lakshmi will be doing Upadesham to Vishwaksena. In that one she says, I am the one with Perumal creating everything. And that is where Kura Thalvan picked everything with the Lakshmi's Kadaksham, with Lakshmi's all these kinds of Nelivi Shulivi, all what she does with her eyebrows, Bhagavan makes this Srishti. Tat Ingida Parayana. Ingidam. So in Lakshmi told that one in Lakshmi Tandram, that is coming. So the most important thing what we need to be a Prabhannan, to be a good Prabhannan, to go to the Moksham. Another important thing, Moksham is a place. It is a Paramapadam. It is what you should strive to go for. It's told only in Pancharatra Sastram. So, all these things are there. If somebody says, Pancharatra Sastram is only for temples, no. It tells you everyday life what you have. That is very important for us. Yes, it tells about the temple. But what are we going to do with that one? We have to be good. We have to do Prabhatti. We have to follow the Panchakala Prakriya and everything. We have to believe Moksham is there. We have to say Param Yogam Perumal and all of them. We have to have the idol worship. Where do you get all this Jnanam? Only from this one. That is why Sarva Agama. So Gajendran is unbelievably intelligent when he says, he put Agama Sastram first, Vedas only second. Because we are blind on Vedas. Even great people get confused. So that is why Perumal, take that one, make a nice juice and essence and give it to us through the Agama Sastram. So whenever somebody says Agama Sastram, we should have the utmost respect for that. Without that one, we cannot have Prabhati at all. Okay. Maharnavaya. Next one is coming. Arnava means ocean. Sea. Maha Arnava. Big, huge, mighty sea. Mighty sea. The reason why it is, when you look at that one, look at the ocean. And outside, what do you see? Keep on waves coming. So much all of them. It looks like Bhagavan is getting angry. Bhagavan is doing all of them. Only you see the end of that. Ocean is so huge. Maybe 0.0001% has got the waves. The rest of them are very calm. Bhagavan is always calm. Only outside the waves, you think. Why the waves are there? Because that's a shore. Because we have this kind of, our kind of indriyams, all our pragrithi mandalam. That is why Bhagavan has to give the punishment and rewards. That is what the waves you have. But in general, Bhagavan is very calm. That is what the ocean is. Says, Maharnavaya, not small. You may say, oh, small ocean, sir, because it's got waves so much, the calm part is so small. No, it is not. Maharnavaya, huge ocean. What you see, the waves is nothing, negligible. And the waves are there. Why? Because what you throw, it has to come back to you. That is the reason. So, aduvum avanadu innarule. When the ocean gets angry, that is because it wants to return back the things to you. So when the Bhagavan gets angry on you, you think like that, it is to correct only you. That is why Maharnavaya. See, when you look at each word, what you might have thought of that one, unbelievably this Gajendran compressed everything into that one. Again, as Uddhava Gita, we saw that one. Ocean is one of the 24 gurus in Avadhuta's explaining. It returns everything back. It doesn't keep anything with him, that one. Abhavargaya parayanaya. Abhavargam, we told, that is the moksham, even though it says heaven. Parayanaya, highest place, ayana, movement into that one. That's what. Lord, you are abhavargam parayanam. Abhavargam is a moksham. Parayanam means para, highest. Ayana means going towards. I am going towards the moksham. That is abhavarkaya parayanaya. That is what he is asking. Namaha. I am doing sharanagadi. Sharanagadi for not tomorrow I get a promotion or something else has to happen. Out of all this world, the next sloka is going to make sure correctly out of all these material things, he wants to say. That is why he says, abhavarkaya parayanaya. Moksham, highest place towards. This is the highest path to go to the moksham. The path and the ends. The ubhayam and the palan. Rendum, you are the one. You are the same. That is why abhavarkaya parayanaya. So, final end product, what you want to get, purushartham and the hidam is the same. Tattvam, I've been crying so much. It's only you. I'm nothing. That is what he's saying here. Why he says like that one, in Bhagavadam, in previous chapter one, Askandam, it says, akamaha sarvakamova mokshakama udharadhihi divrena bhakti yogena yajade purusham param. Beautiful. Akamaha. Sir, I'm not interested in anything. Even that attitude, he has to bless you. First, you have to understand. Don't say like that. Akamaha. Nothing. What he blesses, that's what you have. Don't get that ego. Okay, that's what Nagushan had. I don't have no indriyama, asaya and everything. No desires for my senses. Sarva kamo. I'm interested in everything. Anywhere from the needle all the way to the surgam, aishwaryam, indra padavi, brahma padavi. Everything I'm interested in. Moksha kama udharadi. He separated those three. What you're not interested, you are interested in everything. Everything in the material world, in the pragrithi mandalam. Moksha kama Udharadhi. Very carefully, Udharadhi. One who has got the broad knowledge. So, one who has got the broad knowledge, it is closer to moksha. Moksha, kama, udharadi. That is why they put that one. The more knowledge you will get, first you will not be interested in anything. I don't want anything, I already ate full. Why don't you take a sample, this jalebi? They broke a piece and give you. At the end of the day, a dozen is gone. Sarva. So you start with akama, sarva kama. Then you really, oh boy, why did I do that one? So the cycle keeps on going. At some point you want none of these things. What I want, the currency what I want, the place what I want is none of these things. We need something else. So the ubhayam is different, the palan is different. You have to know that. That is why you say ubhaya palan. So akamaha sarvakamava mokshakama udharadi. Let's take all the three people. One is not interested. One is interested in everything. One is interested in moksham. Divrena bhakti yogena. Divrena bhakti yogena. Krishna loves that word. Very, very unshakable. You have to put your mind fix on him. Tumtu sarvam parityache snegam sonyana bandushu maya vesya mana samyaku. Mayi aveshya mana samyaku. Nobody can say like that. Put your mind onto me, steady. Not one day I do, next day I cannot. When I am good, I do. When I have a problem, I cannot. Only when you put your mind. So he says, Divrena Bhakti Yogena. With great force. Tailadhari. Tailadhari. Not only the time, the intensity, the attention. Everything has to be there. Intensity. Divrena. So much you need great force. By Bhakti only. Yajade Purusham Param. One should be worshipping the Bhagavan. That is what. This Gajendra read the Bhagavatam before it come to the 8th chapter. So in the 2nd chapter, this is what told by the Bhagavan. So he knew that one. That is what I need, that one. Whether you need anything or nothing or moksham, only Bhagavan can give that one. So when you have a choice to ask the dad, I don't want anything, dad, or I want this book, or I want this computer, I want this card, just give me your plastic. That is what the moksham you are asking. Just give me the card. That is what, yes, divrena, you ask that one. Who will do that one? Moksha kama udharadi. Udhara means brat in this case. Udharadi means all the intelligence. The intelligent person will not ask petty things. Like Mukura Aige Singer says, ஆசையே இல்லைங்கிறவன் நிமிந்தாண்டா பேராசக்காரன் ஹியூஜ் கிரீடியா ஆல் அதர் திங்ஸ் பகவான் கிவ்ஸ் ஹி சேஸ் நோ கிவ் மீ ஒன்லி தட் ஸோ ஹீ இஸ் தி மோஸ்ட் கிரீடி பர்சன் ஸோ வி ஆர் ஆல் கிரீடி பர்சன் வி ஆஸ்க் ஒன்லி ஒன் அண்ட் ஆஃப்டர் தட் வி டோன்ட் ஹேவ் டு ஆஸ்க் எனி திங் வென் தே கிவ் தி பிளாஸ்டிக் வி கேன் யூஸ் இட் எனி டைம் நோ ப்ராப்ளம் ஸோ வென் யூ கம் ஐ கிருஷ்ணா சேஸ் லைக் தட் ஒன் ஓவர் ஹியர் தட் இஸ் வாட் கஜேந்திர பிக் தட் ஒன் ஸோ ஐ குட் ஹவ் ஆஸ்க் ஃபார் எனி திங் But Bhagavan, when you give me that one, what is this shariram? It's already been dead. I know you will give me the highest one. You are going to take me parayana. So he says that parayanam, highest place you're going to take. I don't have to ask. The highest place may be the best hospital next so that they can cure you. Or take the life out and take me to the moksham or whatever it is. You know what is best. So that is why parayana, parayana, the right, highest, supreme place, I don't know. You take me there. That is what he is saying over there. Again in another Bhagavatam. So from 2nd chapter, it is 6th chapter. It's coming. Narayana para sarve na kudaschana pibhyadi. Sorga bavarga narageshu Abituliyartha darshanaha. Gajendran did not say this one. He had it in his mind. He says, Narayana para. Those, Gajendra does not use Narayana yet. This is previously coming from the 6th chapter. In there, Narayana para. People who worship Narayana as the Paradevadai, as the Paramatma, final God, the Lord Supreme, when they do that, Na kudaschana pibhyadi. For anything, they will not be afraid of. Who should I be afraid of? There's nothing to be afraid of. Because Imbiramana so beautifully said, there is nothing to be afraid of, there is nothing to despair of. Why? Atmayatrai Bhagavan Sadhinam. Dehayatrai Karma Adhinam. Idhikku Karendanagil. Why do you cry for this? That's what he was saying. So there's nothing to be, if you are afraid of, you have to have something to want to be afraid of. Actually, you don't want anything. Oh, you are scared. Your bank balance is zero. So you are worried the bank is going to be there or not. That is what we are. We don't own the body. We don't own the soul. There's nothing to be afraid of. So beautifully says, Narayana para. Only you are doing with Sriman Narayana. You understand him. He is the Ubayam. He is the Palan. When you have that confident survey on anything, Nakudasya Pibhyadi. They are not afraid of anything. Sorga. Abhavarga Narageshu. Here, it did not say moksham. Because when you say Narayana, he will take care of it. I don't have to say that one. You put me in Swargam. You put me in Abhavargam. Abhavargam here is a moksham because you put a Swargam there. So Abhavargam is a moksham, but he did not say that one. You can think of Swargam is one place. Abhavargam maybe in a higher place, like Brahma's place. Okay? More than the Sorgalogam. Okay. You can think of. Or you can think of Moksham. Whether you put in any of this place, Narageshu, Bhagavan, Abhi Tulyartha Darshanaha. All of them doesn't make any difference. Where do you hear this one? Mugundamala. Kulasegara Alvar says that one. Hey Bhagavan, it doesn't matter how many Janmas you give me. Where do you put me and everything? I don't feel anything at all. All I want to do, think about you. You are Smaranai. That's all I need. Why? Narayana Paraha. That is what it is. So, where you draw the land, every point is collinear. Whether you take from Mugundamala, whether you take from previous Bhagavadam sloka, or here Gajendran says over here, all of them says, Bhagavan, you take me to the right place. This Atma is given to you. This is a stolen property. Atma Nikshebam I already returned. I never have to worry about it. Bharanyasam. Bhara Samarpanam. What it means? You have already given the bharam, the load to him. Then why are you worrying about it? All I am doing, enjoying. So Gajendran says, this crocodile is biting. All the pus and all the blood is coming. I don't feel anything. Just like Prahladan. I am feeling it is a nice AC room. I am staying there. That is what Gajendra says. Abhi tulyartha darshanaha. All of them equal. Okay. How beautiful he says. So, so finally what it says. After studying all this Vedaischa sarvam ahameva vedyaha. Krishna says. When you understand all of them. Bhagavan is everything. That is what he understands. What you? This one is from the 6th chapter. I don't know which context is one of the avadharams. It says that one. So I can go and find out. So one of the avadharam previously talks only 10th only it comes to the Krishna avadharam. So in the 6th chapter. So 6th skandam of Bhagavadam. Bhagavadam. Not Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavadam. So that's why I said the second skandam and 6th skandam. So Gajendran read Bhagavadam and come to the 8th skandam and he starts crying. Before he called Perumal, he has to know, how do I call? How do I call you? He wants to know. So all this knowledge he has, I get everything. Then only he goes to Perumal. So coming back here, what we saw here, Namo Namaste Agila Karanaya நிஷ்காரணாய அற்புத காரணாய சர்வ ஆகம ஆம்னாய மகார்ணவாய நமோ அபவர்காய பராயணாய. லாட் ஆஃப் ஹெவி வேர்ட்ஸ் ஹி புட் ஓவர் தேர். ஸோ யூ ஹேவ் டு சிட் அண்ட் கீப் ஆன் டைஜஸ்டிங், திங்க் அபவுட் ஆல் ஆஃப் தம். எவ்ரி சிங்கிள் வேர்ட் இஸ் பியூட்டிஃபுல். ஆஃப் ஆல் திஸ் திங்ஸ் தி மோஸ்ட் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் இஸ் சர்வ ஆகம ஆம்னாய, பிகாஸ் திஸ் ஹோல் ஸ்லோகா wants to show the greatness of Pancharatra Sastra. That is what. So each sloka is emphasizes one, but we understand the Agama Sastram because of the Prabhati and all the iconic forms we worship and everything, Bhagavata Kaingaryam and what our Panchakala Prakriya, everything is given from there. That is why Agama Sastram is very important. We cannot study Agama Sastram also because we don't have the knowledge. That is why Acharyas have extracted that one and given to you. You do this one. Desian has done so many of them. Unbelievable. Pancharatra Raksha, he has done one on that one. How do you preserve all those kinds of things? So, there is, we cannot even imagine how Swami Desian has done all of them so that millions of years people can follow without any conflict, without any ambiguity. Okay. So, we'll stop at this one. Next sloga, I start that one and then we'll go through. Gunarani schanna sidushma bhaya tat chobha visbhujida manasaya naishkarmya bhavena vivarjida agama swayam pragasaya namaskaromi. Unbelievable words also here also. Every word we have to split and it may take another two sessions to go through all of them. But here in essence what he wants to show, Guna Aranis Channa. Aranikata, wood. In the wood, there is a fire inside. When the rishis are doing, they are not going to go to the next house, can I borrow some agni? So they took two sticks and they do that one, the agni comes out of that, that's how they will start. So, within that one, ellile enna irukku. With the sesame, you got the oil. Where do you see all of them? Gatyatrayam. Shanagari Gatyam. Go back into that. Okay, next class we'll go through that one. Shanagari Gatyam, Imbirumana took from here. So, to Aranikata, if you do that one, you'll get the nirupu. So, Bhagavan, the manifested part is basically the wood. But the wood cannot stay without the agni inside. Similarly, the manifested part it is, you are in that one. So, sarva agni, you are the, like the agni kind of everything. Takshobha visbhujya, takshobha, kshobha means, what it means, ulukardu, atardu. So, that is coming from Uddhava Gita. How Bhagavan does the srishti. All the three gunas will be calm. 33 one third. Bhagavan has to shake that one. That is how he starts the srishti. Takshobha visbhurjida. Visbhurjida. He outstretched that one. From that one, he is pulling and is creating. That is what he is saying. Visbhurjida. Vishwam bhurjida. In a nice way, it is coming out. Like you're doing the churning. From that one, he does. And he does the srishtiya, that one. Manasaya. Only by Sangalpam. You don't have to do all of them. So beautiful. In previous one, he says, you are the karana for everything. Your karanam also, just your thought process. You don't. Atpuda karana. You don't have to move anything. So all these things, there is a small problem here when you go and look at the explanation. Most of the explanation given only by Advaitis or Dvaitam, they tell in a different way. Naishkarmya bhavena vivarchida. Agama swayam pragasaya. Naishkarmya bhavena. People who do everything without any return in their head. Enlightened people. Agama vivarchida. They don't have to follow sastras. Okay, agama vivarjidaya. Okay, we'll explain next class. What Visishtadvaitam would explain this one, but transposing the words correctly. Okay, so what they are explaining over here, that's why I want, if you go back and study Uddhava Gita, this is Bhagavadam, from explanation from Advaitam or Madhvacharya Sampradayam, this is what you would be reading. But that's not correct according to our Sampradayam. So, Naishkarmya Bhavena Vivarjida does not say like that one, even though it looks like that. You can make any meaning out of that. That's the problem with Sanskrit. That's the problem with the slokas. You move around, you get any meaning you want. Agama Swayam Pragasaya. What it means, actually, tell you, next class we'll look at that. Naishkarmya Bhavena, the person who understand the manifested world, the Agni is inside, without that manifested world will not be there. He understand the manifested world is useless. That is, tum tu sarvam parityajya snegam swajana bandhushi, understand that one, he will do vivarjida. What he will do? Vivarjida of the wood. He will hold on to the Agni. So, we will live out the pragrati, we will hold on to you. Why he will hold on to you? Because Agama Swayam Pragasa, you are the one enlightened in Agama Shastra. So that is the way we have to explain over here. In the next class we will do. Kavidharkika Simmaya Kalyana Udasalini Simare Venkadesaya Vedhanta Gurave Namaha Simare Nekamanta Maha Deshigaya Namaha.